today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour. From Arizona to Barcelona, from Botswana to Tijuana, from Oklahoma to Tacoma, we'd like to come to you at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So what do we have going on today? Well, it's a kind of a hurry up and wait day as far as I can tell. We're bouncing around in the upper part of this trading range, which was originally 3050 to 3250. Went a little bit above that. We didn't really have any kind of huge sell signal to the downside. We've had a little bit of weakness, but I mean little. And if we go to the sit rep today, it's earnings and more earnings this week, especially when we get to some of the stuff we'll talk about later, like AMD, which is tomorrow night. But the volume is low going down. The volume is going low, is low going up, which generally means tighter and tighter trading ranges until you break out of that. And when we last spoke, had a lot of people interested in silver and the SLV and were asking my opinion. And I said after we had two gaps, you want to hold for the third gap. We got the third gap today. Probably the textbook of a three-gap play. That generally means you want to take your money right then. It doesn't mean you will be right, but it will mean that you are doing the right thing. I was never so impressed in reading a book as The Theory of Poker from David Sklansky. If you want to read a good dissertation on how to think about making a trading plan and figuring out what you're going to do in different positions in the market, a great book. Now, of course, poker much different than the stock market. You've got to always throw in some money into every hand where poker, with trading, you can sit back and wait for the big fat pitches. But an excellent treatise on figuring out what your odds are of winning. And the guy is nothing short of a genius. Great book to read, even if you're not going to play poker. Get you in that mindset of how to figure out odds. Now, in the three-gap play, 80% of the time, you will be, if you get three identical out of standard deviation gaps like we're seeing in silver, you sell the third one. If you get two, you wait for the third. Now, do you always get it? No. But the right thing to do is wait for it. The best thing to do is sell it when you get the third gap. Now, does it mean instantly headed lower tomorrow? The answer is no. But over time, generally, you could figure that they're going to fill all those gaps. So you would wouldn't be beyond the scope of reason to think you get back to 1850 in silver in the not too distant future. That's part of the three-gap play. One is you get two, 80% chance you're going to get a third. On the third one, if it's as big and strong as the other ones, generally you have what is called an exhaustion top. And most people are kind of too scared to get into it. Now, is this every stock in the world, every commodity? No. The entrance and exits in gold and silver are very narrow. Could hang out up here for a few days. It could come back down to the 3x3 displaced moving average and actually catch support. But my guess would be at a minimum, you'd want to say that there's a 95% chance this gets back down into the low 20s. So, you know, maybe you fill it, maybe it moves around. But ideally, if you get this and you're a shorter term trader, you pray that you get back down to like the 19 and a quarter, 1950 cents, something like that, 1950, and you get an opportunity to swing the bat once again. You got a high volume, or you're going to have a high volume high here, probably going to get retested one day. The question is just how far do you pull back? Again, entrances and exits are incredibly narrow in silver, so you can have swings that are bigger than most people would see in regular stocks and most commodities out here. But you know what? The odds are just so good. You get two, you want to hold for three. At three, the odds are so good that you hit a top that you want to sell. And, you know, when I was talking about poker, probably the best thing is that the best poker players have got a mental attitude where they don't reward themselves or punish themselves if they did the right thing. If they did the wrong thing, then they can't. But if you got to, if you're at the very last hand in poker and your opponent's looking across the table and he's got one card in 40 left in the deck that could actually beat you, you kind of want to push your odds at that point. He's got a 1 in 40 chance of winning. Same kind of thing. When you get the odds that are anywhere in the 80% range of anything in the stock market, that's about as good as you're ever going to get. So does it always work out? No. But you should not punish yourself if you do the right thing. If it goes higher, don't worry about it. But generally, the problem would be that you get a little greedy up here, and then it starts its move back, and you never get out of it. One of the best quotes that I have is, what's this guy's name? I'm going to think about it. Anyway, I'll remember his name after the break, I'm sure. But he says, it's important to buy gold, but it's much more important to sell it. And when you get some kind of huge move like that, always a great thing to do. Okay, do you miss the scenario that gold's above and runs to 3,000 or 300 bucks? I take it. I take that's in silver, right? Don't know exactly what the question is. Do you dismiss the scenario this holds above 2120? I don't know. All I'm telling you is that historically, when this pattern develops, 80% chance that you go back and you eventually get into that first gap out there. And then it tends to want to consolidate for a while. You get a retest of the top, and then generally that's the next time where you get a big, as Tim Ord calls it, an impulse wave higher. That's one that just kind of goes up on this one, maybe 10, 15 cents, 20 cents a day, something like that, and just never quits. We've seen those in many of the tech stocks where they just, you know, you get 2% and a half, something like that, just continues going higher. But generally, you don't get an impulse wave out of three gaps. We'll be back in a minute.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we're back. Anyway, we'll get into a lot of stuff going on. Did I cover everything? Let's see here. Third gap higher in silver. Oh, I was going to talk about AMD a little bit. Of course, Intel dropped the chalupa on doing anything. AMD after the bell tomorrow night. I think they ran all the shorts out. This thing had been hammered forever. I'd probably been long it on and off 5 or 6 times. I wasn't long it for this. You had a higher high back here at 59 on June 10th. I just never really saw anything out here that said it was ready to go. And wasn't really sure that it was Intel failing that would make it go higher. Of course, Intel, as I said, dropped the Baby Ruth in the punch bowl. But I've been warning about this for at least a year, 2 years. There's nothing like somebody that runs off all your best engineers. That is the current CEO, mostly because he's very good at political infighting, not really that great in technology. Basically took out the previous CEO, which was probably the smartest man in the world at the present time for designing technology and integrated circuits, and dug up something, found out something from 10 years ago when he was dating a coworker. And in this environment, but it kind of blew it out of proportion, got him canned, took over the company. And since then, they've done a whole lot of nothing. He's been, as I said, pretty easy if you're a CFO to go in and make a company look good for a little while. Very tough in a tech company to make it look good for the long term. You can look at Apple and just say that they haven't had one new successful product since Steve Jobs. Even the earbuds, which is keeping them above water here, is nothing but a product that was started long before Steve Jobs left. You have a little pop-up here. If you went above the 3-day again and then gave it up real quick, I'd probably look at it, but not too bad. You've got more earnings this week also in the feeder stocks, i.e. the companies that actually supply Apple this week. So maybe we get a little bit more out of it. I mean, you had some decent volume, but it just doesn't, you know, we'll see whether or not what these companies are saying about what Apple's ordering for the fall. And they'll have to. And I think it starts tomorrow or Wednesday. I'll look through the earnings. But you're pretty close to finding out whether Apple is going to be the same as Intel and the rest. But I don't think so. Sales have been real good. Every time we get these big unemployment checks, people race to Best Buy and buy the phones. I don't know what else you could say. Maybe people are looking. Certainly in that whole area, there's four or five phones that have shipped in the last week for 5G technology. There's only one thing that you want to do is make sure that you get channel 71 on any new phone you get. That way it will work out. It will work much better if you leave town and you're going across the state or something. The channel 71 is the old UHF television band on it. And there are a lot of phones, of course, that didn't have it. But now that's kind of the backup. If you live in rural areas, you want to make sure you get that, or you get any new 5G phones. Make sure that it handles and falls back to channel 71. There are a lot of them out there. A lot of sales right now on older phones, and there's nothing wrong with getting an older phone and keeping it for a year, waiting for 5G stuff to really roll out. But that's what Apple's fourth quarter is going to be this year. It's all going to be about pushing 5G and 5G apps. We haven't seen the killer app. And, of course, in technology, the killer app is actually what drives something. But there are a few thoughts out there about what it will do. But probably it's going to, at least at the beginning, it's going to be Apple, is going to be games. That are going to be games against other folks. Because basically you're going to have latency, which is how long it takes for a signal to leave your phone and get back to it, that is pretty close to what you would get at a home location. Even on the radio signal to the phone. So right now, half a second, 1 second latency is not beyond the scope of reason for any phone. So you're not playing anybody anything unless it's Words with Friends or some other Scrabble game. If it moves, it's going to be too slow to be it. And, of course, Apple's really kind of thinking that at least at the beginning, a lot of playing against other people is going to be a big part of getting the 5G thing off the bottom. Any other kind of real-time data app? I mean, stock prices, unless you're trying to do high-frequency trading on your phone, in which case you're an idiot to begin with, doesn't really matter. But anything that bounces back and forth at a high rate, probably going to be an issue. So games to begin with is at least what Apple's looking at. What else do we have? We're up 18 points on the S&P cash. Dow is up 59. NASDAQ's up 152. Russell's up 8. So, again, not getting a real clear signal anywhere. Tesla kind of popping back above 1,500 as we speak. Got to 1,505. Today, I still suspect that it's going to have problems over time, especially as things probably as tensions increase between the U.S. and China. What else do we have? Okay. Yeah. AMD 7163. You can give me a call at 877-927-6648, or you can email me at path@tfnn.com. Okay. Okay. Well, let's just go through some of these charts. Like I said, it's very tough to find a lot of signals in the market. A handful of these stocks actually kind of interesting. Adtran got right up to the high back on the 22nd. It's just gone sideways on fairly light volume, 137,000 shares today, going back into the June 8th high. Of course, I wouldn't be shorting a $12 stock. Ameren, a bunch of these companies in the energy space for generating electricity. Ameren's a big electrical producer in the Midwest, others out here. Pretty good sign that $80.73 is going to hold. The April 9th high there had a 1.66 million shares. Got into it with a little less than 800,000 shares and came back down. It just looks to me like a bigger trading range out here. When we get back, we'll look at AGEN, A-G-E-N, a genius. We'll look at some of these other ones. Also, as I return...
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today.
Hi folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we're back. Did I get everything here? Okay, I got that. Okay. Okay. You can email me at path@tfnn.com. I keep clicking this thing and it keeps coming back. the Baby Ruth Chalupa signal. Man, that's a great name for one, isn't it? The Chalupa signal. I think that would probably do well. I'm a big fan of the Turbo Encabulator, if you know that one. The best signal that there is. Okay. Oh, and we were back to looking at a genius. Did I bring this up? I think I did. I just moved it around a little bit. This one, fairly light volume breaking through the previous lows. Company is clinical stage oncology company, so I don't know if it means that much. He had 3 million shares back on June 12th. At $3.24, 3 million shares. On Friday, at 2.5 million shares. So just a little lighter volume, but today, very light volume. If that closes back above 324, may give you a look there in the biotech space. Other biotechs out here kind of finding or trying to find some lows. Last low on Apellis Pharmaceuticals. That's APLS, 28.74 on May 14th. At 1.1 million shares, got into it with 770,000 shares on Friday, 244 today. So again, you want those to pull back above and close above 28.74 to get a buy signal on them. AY, which is Atlantica Sustainable Infrastructure Company. Don't know about much about this one, but any close below a 3x3 would suggest that this thing's coming back to about $27. BDX, Beckton Dickinson and Company, came down with a huge amount of juice back on the 6th of February, really before all this got going. So you know this one had problems. Tried to get back into this gap down twice on April 28th on 2 million shares. On July 20th, with 1.4 million shares, just kind of going out here. Again, this one kind of looks like a very long consolidation right near these highs up so far today under 571,000 shares. So some of these are looking like they're getting fairly long in the tooth if the market does not start heading higher. Bungie, some of these other industrial companies looking like they could possibly fail, going back to the gap down of March 9th in Bungie. This company probably has a bunch of debt. As I remember, they were buying all kinds of other companies. What do they call those? Drag miners, drag things, drag claws. Anyway, they just drag stuff around to dig it up. But down on March 9th, drag lines, that's what it is. Thank you. Down on the 9th of March, volume was okay, 2.2 million shares. You just never really got into that, kind of gone sideways out here. Again, a lot of these are just paused right at the breakout level. So if they don't go up, probably going to go down fairly soon. What is this? I don't know why I have that one in there. Got a couple. Okay. Kind of interesting to see this south of the border bank, Banco Santander from Mexico, BSMX, with fairly light volume through the June 11th low at $3.25. Had 800,000 shares. You got about half that so far today. Citibank also kind of coming back into what has been a support area for this for a while. No juice today at all at 1 million shares. CNMD, which is ConMed, another one that looks like it's really starting to buck into some fairly extensive downside action. If it got it $90, the volume remained light, I'd probably short it no matter what the market did. Delta Airlines, he who Delta'd, smelt it, probably. Interesting airworthiness directive from Boeing, from the FAA, about a valve on their engines because the airliners have been sitting so long starting to have this little valve start to corrode a little bit, and it needs to open and close. It's probably not a big deal. I caught a news article about it. Sounded like the end of the world. Then I went to my trusty, significant source on jet engines to find out that it's not a big deal. But news got to make a big deal about everything. Actually, does not look that bad, which is kind of counterintuitive. You wanted 31 million shares today to even just test the previous low. You got about 14 million so far. I would still think that if you wanted to buy this thing, it's probably going to get to 24 or lower, and it's probably still too early to buy it. Drive Shack, interesting pattern, did break out back on May 20th. I went to $3.05, back down, beautiful consolidation. What do these guys do? What do these guys do that other guys don't do? Let's see here. Owns and operates golf-related leisure. You got to think golf is a social distancing sport by nature. Operates through traditional golf property segments, entertainment golf. I don't know. If I knew more about golf, maybe I'd do something. Maybe we've got a golf head. What do they call people that are really into golf? Golf heads? Don't know. Not into golf. But does look very interesting out here. And my guess is you could probably, COVID or not, probably had a lot of people out there doing it. I mean, golfing. Golfers, you know. EXP. Okay. Eagle Materials. Again, some light volume back up at these very inflective positions. This gap down on May 6th with 583,000 shares. Busted into that area again on May 5th with about the same volume. Today, 169,000 shares. So again, getting fairly close. I like these kind of double tops after these huge gaps down. No sign yet that you should pull the trigger. But if we do start pulling back, here's some stuff to look at. GOLD. We'll look at this when we come back. Barrett Gold, little gap above the previous high. You wanted 30 million shares. We got 22 million so far. Be back in a minute.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And we're back. Looking at Barrick Gold again, you wanted something like 31 million shares. You got 22 at the moment. So just keep an eye on that. Again, kind of long in the tooth for gapping up here, but yeah, what do you know? Hormel, are we all going to be eating Spam come Christmas? Because we've degenerated it into everybody playing Thunderdome and watching old reruns of Mad Max for tips on surviving the coming onslaught of cannibalism to survive. I do not know, but you've got a pretty high volume, March 18th high, $51.02 back on March 18th. Apparently, that was when we were thinking we were all going to be eating each other. You're into it with about 1.1 million shares on Friday. So I don't know. It's not really backing off, but I don't know. I look at people a little differently these days. You think he'd be tasty or not? Anyway, Host Hotels and Resorts does look like maybe it's finding some kind of low. May 18th higher. And came up with 28 million shares, back with almost 10 million shares on July 9th, and about 7 so far today, maybe another 10 million share day by the end of it, but certainly not expanding. You might get a chance to buy it at this 906 if everything turns around. Break the deal, face the wheel. Okay. Hersha Hospitality Trust, another one in the same sector. It looks kind of about the same thing. Up on 700,000 shares, in with 200,000 shares today. ITW, Illinois Tools Work, got a lot of industrial companies sitting up with very light volume at previous highs, but not backing off either. ITW 188.22 with 1 million shares. You're up into that today with about 361,000 shares. Hard to figure out why a tool works would go that unless there's going to be a big spending bill, which I think the spending is already taken care of. Maybe there's something else that's happening. Loco. This place has been around for forever. This is one that thought it was going to be the same thing as Chipotle. Never quite made it there. Banging around the $16 range once again. Fairly light volume today. I don't think they can make chicken into what Mexican food or semi-Mexican food, if you're talking about Chipotle, is done. Lululemon spiked a couple of days ago at 324. Actually, this one's starting to interest me on the short side. MKS Instruments, another one testing the previous high of 800,000 shares back on February 13th with about half that a couple days ago, up today on 300,000 shares. Knee, from the people who say knee. If you're a big Monty Python fan, you will know the people that say knee. If not, you are one of the other folks. March 18th, 3.7 million shares. Got into it with 2 million shares on Friday, pulling back a little. Again, none of these are falling off the edge of the earth, but they are just hanging up there. So you might get a little push and then a failure on no volume, which is kind of what we've got here, no volume up or no volume down on most of it. PepsiCo, I wonder what these guys do. Anyway, banging against the gap down back from March 6th that had about 7 million shares. Hit it twice, very light volume test again on Friday. Not doing much here today. Procter & Gamble. Question about ROK. Is that ROK in the USA? We have to do a John Mellencamp something or other. Same thing, light volume test. Back up here, 230.71, the June 5th high. 1 million shares into it today with half that. And, you know, let's say it does 700,000 shares. Okay, missing the C. Okay. Okay. Yeah, a lot of these things look extremely weak. Prologix, another one of the biotechs. Previous high, 6.4 million shares at $98.35 back on February 21st. Today, a little under 2 million shares. But it looks like you're going to hold the 101. But if it doesn't get some volume here in the next couple of days, should pull back into the trading range. Pinnacle West Capital Corporation, thing's been banging at 83, three times out here. This is on the big gap down of about 2.2 million shares. We got into it with about 800,000 shares a couple days ago. PRAA, this is a PRAR group. Into its previous high with less than half the volume of the March 3rd high, $39.58. What are these people? They're apparently in a group, which is not good, not politically correct in this day of social distancing to be in a group. Financial and business services company engages in purchase collection and management of portfolios of non-performing loans. My God, they're Shylocks. Is that what that is? What is it? Non-performing loans. Sounds to me like collectors, right? Involved in the acquisition of accounts that are primarily in the unpaid obligations of individuals owed to credit grantors, which includes banks and other types of consumer, retail, and auto financing companies. Which reminds me of the ad that I will remember until the day I die, because I was getting out of high school, there one ad that ran all the time. The Loan Arranger, financing innocent victims of bankruptcy and repossession. Even back then, they had those buy here, pay here lots where they tow people out. The difference now is that they replace the computers in those cars with ones that they can turn off remotely. So if you don't pay, they just turn the car off after it's been sitting for 15 minutes. And lock the car up, and no one can tell anybody why it doesn't start again. And then they just wait until it shows up. Someone comes by and tells them where it's at. Cops call them or whatever. And they go back and get their car and try to sell it to somebody else yet again. Anyway, interesting idea. This one actually sitting at the highs. I don't know. Going into if you are on the bearish side of the market, I don't know if I would want to be getting a whole bunch of more of stuff that people could not pay. But that's just me. But maybe that's why it's up there on no volume.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, bam! As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
That it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
I almost forgot my history. Today in 1949, the first jet-propelled airliner, the British de Havilland Comet, makes its maiden test flight. Could do about 470, 480 miles an hour, and, of course, was actually pretty good. Of course, it was pressurized. One of the things that they hadn't figured out is that you can't make the windows of an airliner square. They have to be rounded, or that's where the stress of expanding pressure at altitude and depressurizing the plane every time you land will eventually make stress cracks. By 1953, 1954, they started falling out of the skies. And, of course, by the time they got everything turned around, Boeing and Douglas. McDonnell Douglas after a while. But Douglas had their jet planes already. It didn't really leave a lot of room for a older plane that had a lot of older technology in it by the time that they got it all sorted out in 1956 and 7. I wanted to talk about that with Boeing just because the pattern is not that bad. In Boeing, it still has another $3 lower to go. You want to test and probably pierce 166 and then close back above it. 103 million shares on June 11th. That was kind of the exhaustion low. Maybe you get a little bit more. But down today on 24, 25 million shares, maybe 30 by the close, which is lower than the 50 million shares back on June 26, too. So hey, maybe in the next couple of days, maybe we either make a low in Boeing or you figure that it's time to look elsewhere. In the meantime, sell when you can, not when you have to. We will return tomorrow, same bat channel, same bat time.